Yep, see you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Hey, would you like some water?
The city of Ames is flooded with water, but there's not a drop to drink out of the tap. Good afternoon, everyone. There is some good news this afternoon for Ames. Interstate 35 between Ames and Des Moines has reopened in the northbound lanes, and the southbound lanes are expected to open sometime later today.
Now, that's the good news. The bad news, Ames City officials say residents may have to wait until next week before water out of the tap is safe to drink. News Channel 8's Angie Hunt begins our floods of 2010 coverage from South Duff Avenue in Ames. Angie?
Well, Molly, as you mentioned, we're here along South Duff. Another sign of improvement because it is now reopened to traffic, making it much easier to get around town today. But you can see there's still a couple of lanes here along Duff with some water. Also, if you look across into the Walmart parking lot, you can still see a lot of water there. Several businesses pumping water out this morning. But as you said, water continues to be the big issue here. The city has set up several water stations where residents can go and get free water. Volunteers are there handing out gallons. They do have a limited supply, so they're asking people to take only what they need, about a gallon per person, but that is there, free water if you should need it. The city is estimating it'll be next week before Ames will have drinkable tap water. Overnight, the city sat down and really looked at the system. They were able to identify two more water main breaks throughout the city, bringing the total to now 8 water main breaks here in Ames. All these breaks have drained the water towers to dangerously low levels, so people are asked to conserve as much as possible. That means short showers, limiting flushing, so that the city can get the water supply back up to normal.
It really stinks that how it happened. We had the flood, and then they had the water main break, and just one after another. So if they can conserve as much as they can, that'd be great for us.
We're just trying to use as little water as we can and still function.
And residents here in Ames are finding it can be a little challenging to function without that water, but those free water stations are set up throughout town. It's going to kind of vary as to the availability. As you can see behind me, several businesses like the Happy Joe's here on Duff still surrounded with water. Other businesses not even affected by the flooding, though, are closing down voluntarily today because of the limited water supply. The few that are open are being told they have to use bottled water for virtually everything, hand washing, cooking, preparing, everything. But most restaurants have voluntarily shut down. And then other restaurants, as you can see, like the Happy Joe's here on South Duff, it's going to take some time before they can even get in, get cleaned up, and get things reopened. We should mention, if you are going to be using water out of the tap, people are going to notice different varying levels of water pressure throughout the city of Ames. Some may be normal, others are going to be lower than normal. If you do use that water, if you need to use it for drinking or cooking, you're asked to boil it for at least 3 to 5 minutes to make sure it's safe. Molly and Katie.
And Angie, before you go, I know that a lot of students are going to be heading back to school next week, moving into the dorms, the sorority, fraternity houses, apartments. Any idea what the school is telling those students now?
Well, I have not got the latest update from Iowa State this morning. The university is actually shut down today, but you can bet they are making plans to figure out what they're going to need to do for the students who are on campus, because yes, there are some back and living on campus. They are making sure that their essential needs are met and doing the best they can through bottled water and other kinds of, you know, water supplies that they are bringing in. But yeah, that's another challenge they're going to have to prepare for as students come back. But as for today, the university did shut down except for those essential services so that the university can help in the effort to conserve water.
All right, Angie Hunt, thank you very much for that live report.